Here is a true story from Reddit. The link to the story is in the description below. Enjoy. I'm new here, but I have a ton of creepy stories. I'm a creep magnet. The most recent one, though, really unsettled me because it's not my story, it's my little sister's. My parents chose our little neighborhood so long ago because it's in a quiet Canadian town, a safe place with only petty crimes like shoplifting teens or vengeful exes. But recently, there has been a lot of posts on the town's Facebook group about odd happenings, like seeing a man peeking into their low windows. He hasn't been caught or identified despite the Royal Canadian Mounted Police, or RCMP, staying vigilant. Since we live in such a safe place, my parents are okay with their 16-year-old daughter, me, and my 17-year-old sister walking around alone. Last week, I was walking home from work around sunset. I walk home down the slight hill so I have a good view of the whole street. I noticed a very average-looking middle-aged white guy walking down a neighbor's drive, towards the street, looking around. He caught sight of me and nodded in a friendly way, like a resident would. I nodded back, assuming he was a relative of one of the neighbors. He wandered off. You know when you're watching a bad movie and the actors walk like they're acting? He walked like that, overly casual, just moseying down the lane. I ignored it because I can be kind of judgmental, so I just let it go. The next day, I was in the kitchen while my 3-year-old sister, Pearl, was in the living room playing quietly. She's shy, incredibly shy. I was just drying dishes when she ran into the kitchen looking comically shocked. I followed her back to the living room and saw a man disappearing around the hedges onto the street. I realized then that the odd man must have paid a visit and was peeking at my fucking sister. I called it into the RCMP, letting them know I had a sighting and where we lived. He wasn't usually a repeat offender, so I wasn't worried that night. Since it's summer and incredibly hot in Canada right now, I sleep with my window open and a screen to keep the moths out. My bed is against the window with my pillows just under it, and my room is on the bottom floor next to the front door. I was on my laptop late at night, like 2 a.m., when I heard an odd noise, like a rustle. Sometimes we get bears, so I peeked out the window at the garbage just to make sure. Nothing. I went back to dicking around when I heard a jiggle this time, like the screen rattled. It could have been the breeze because the screen's old and loose. I hate when the wind rattles my door and window, so I didn't even look behind me, just reached back and slid the window closed. After a while, I turned off my laptop and silence filled my room without the fans running. I was trying to sleep when I heard the sound of something falling into bushes. I realized, oh fuck, it's gotta be a bear or raccoon fucking with my house again. My sister leaves her window open all the time, so I got up and started down the hall to her room. The way the house is laid out, I could see into my sister's room from my room. Against the light from the street lamp, I watched as someone pulled himself over my sister's window ledge and into her awfully messy room. She was camping with her classmates that night. Thank God. I didn't even think. I just ran across the hall into Pearl's room and locked the door. She was sleeping soundly, so I pulled out my phone and called my mom's cell. She answered angrily. Why the hell are you calling me? What's going on? Are you even home?
Mom, call 911. There's someone in the house.
She started crying and woke up my dad. Their room is upstairs. And my dad called 911 while my mom stayed on the line with me, making sure Pearl and I were safe. The RCMP showed up fast and busted in. The adrenaline had started to leave me, and I was terrified, holding onto my sister's hand, just praying. A rustle came from the outside, and I turned away from the door to look at the window. A dark shape was pressed against Pearl's window. It was Pearl he was after this whole time, since the first time he looked in on us. But since the Mounties were in the house and he knew this, he just took off running. They came in and Pearl started bawling because she had woken up, but I just held her and cried. Nothing scares me. And I mean nothing. But when it comes to her, I just can't. So creepy guy, I hope they catch you. And if you even try to touch my siblings, I swear to God, I will kill you.
Well, I hope you guys enjoyed. Until next time.